Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name's Ray and I'm studying Physical and Natural Sciences at Cambridge. So as you can expect from the title, I got an ASR and A-level for Maths this year, and I'll be going through how. So just for context, I did AQA for Maths, and I did pure statistics and decision slash discrete, whatever your exam board calls it. This might be different from your exam board, but I hope the advice I give will be useful nonetheless. Links to any of the websites or resources I mentioned will be in the description down below. So my first bit of advice is to download your specification. There's a lot of new content in A-level Fervor Maths, some of the things you'll never have seen before or anything similar to before. So the best way to make sure you know everything that you need to is to download and use a specification. So I'd suggest going through it every month or so as you're learning your content in class and just making sure everything your teacher's covering has been covered and that you know it. If there's anything you're unsure on, just go ask your teacher because they know the spec inside out. You can either print it out or get it on somewhere like OneNote or Google Drive so you can annotate it on there instead. I went through my spec several times throughout the year just to make sure I was covering everything, and towards closer to exam time I went through it more frequently until I was completely 100% sure I had all the content down. So I'm going to be talking about how I revised for pure, discrete and statistics separately. So for pure, aside from learning all the content in class with the teacher and having class notes, if you go on Physics and Maths Tutor, there should be some really good notes from the old spec, but just bear in mind that they won't cover everything. So while you might find old FP2 and FP3 notes, whatever old spec equivalent your exam board did, they might not cover everything and there might be some new content which you have to learn to. So for further maths, you have to make sure you have a really good understanding of the material. The textbook can be a good resource, but you can find some pretty solid YouTube videos out there as well. Be sure to search any topics that you don't understand on YouTube. You don't have to watch a video by someone who makes A-level videos. You can watch like a video by Khan Academy on eigenvectors and eigenvalues to make sure that you know it completely. And eigenvectors, eigenvalues are a topic under matrices for AQA for maths. The website Exam Solutions has some really good videos on some topics which don't have many videos on, so like second order differential equations and simple harmonic motion and stuff like that. I made a few flashcards as well which helped me revise for the pure content in Fervor Maths, especially on stuff like finding the determinant of a 3x3 matrix by hand, which is just a method you have to memorize, or the hyperbolic substitutions for integrals and solutions to second order differential equations, basically stuff like that. It's better to just memorize it rather than trying to understand why it is the way it is, at least at this stage. Pure Fervor Maths requires a lot of practice compared to the other modules, and I got most of my practice questions from the textbook and from a website called Integral Maths, which my school had a subscription to. I would suggest asking your teachers if they can get a subscription as well, because it has some really good questions on there. And of course, whichever practice set and past papers your exam board have released, while at this stage there might be very few, I would suggest rinsing them as much as possible so you can get as much out of them. Make sure you've covered all the content before you do it, because you don't want to waste such limited papers. So moving on to decision maths now. Aside from the practice using integral maths and the YouTube videos I mentioned before, here's some more advice. So I think flashcards are definitely a must for decision maths because of the amount of content you have to learn. So you have to memorize some algorithms, you have to learn some definitions for graph theory, you have to learn the properties of groups for group theory. I would suggest making flashcards on it all and using Anki to make those flashcards so you can go through it regularly. I would suggest googling what Anki is if you've never heard of it, or watching some videos and learning how to use it. You can get it on both your computer and your phone, and I should have a series up at some point on how to use it. It should be linked somewhere here. But using that to make your flashcards like I've made over here is definitely helpful. Also, if you do have a graphing calculator, I would suggest learning how to do stuff like row operations on your calculator, and other small techniques.
So one example of a trick you can use on a graphing calculator, if you have one, is to make the simplex algorithm easier to do. If you don't know what simplex is, then you can ignore this. But if you do, then go to matrix and then choose a matrix, I don't know, 3x8. So now we have 3 rows and 8 columns. And if I just start filling this in with a few numbers, it's quite difficult to do one-handed. And then I choose a few more numbers over here. And of course, these will be the actual numbers you have from your simplex table. If you go to row up, then you can choose this button to times a row by a number. So I could times all of row 2 by 5. And now everything on row 2 is 5 times bigger. I can choose to add a multiple of one row to another. So I can choose half of row 2 to be added to row 1. Or I could swap 2 rows. So I can swap row 1 and row 2. Or I could do add one row onto another. So I could add row 2 onto row 1. And that just makes doing simplex a whole lot easier, because you don't have to do each column separately. You can have it do whole rows for you at a time.
But ultimately, just keep practicing questions. But remember, if you do any old spec questions for the algorithms, like traveling salesperson and whatnot, the questions may not be as routine as they are on the old spec when it comes down to your exam. So moving on to statistics now. Once again, aside from doing questions on integral maths and watching YouTube videos and exam solutions, everything I've mentioned before, here's some more advice. Flashcards can be useful for some areas, like remembering Yates's continuity correction or exponential distribution and some derivations you have to do and stuff like that. And once again, I'd practice using a calculator, especially when it comes to the amount of distributions you have to know. So the Poisson binomial, exponential, normal distribution. Try and get quick at using these on your calculator. And if you're doing chi-square tests and you have a graphing calculator, I would suggest learning how to use a calculator to do it. You can just find any old video online from anyone on how to use it. Ultimately, just practice, practice, and practice. Try and get as many questions as you can. Practice them. Any topics you're struggling with, ask teachers for help. Ask them for more questions, they should be able to find it for you, especially if they've been teaching further maths for quite a while. You can find some questions from the textbooks, which are really useful. I would suggest doing as many as you can, but obviously it's unrealistic to set yourself the target of doing all the questions. So just do a few questions from each topic, and if you're confident with that topic, then move on. Like some of the harder questions, if you're confident, move on to the next. If you're struggling on the harder questions for some of the topics, then try doing the easier ones or trying to revise the content first. Also, if you are on AQA, then there's a teaching guidance full of questions for pure discrete mechanics, statistics, everything. I'll have that linked down in the description below. While these questions do not have mark schemes, they're still really good practice. And as you're going through all these questions, I would suggest making a mistakes file. Split all the common mistakes you make by topic, and just before exams or topic tests and stuff, just go through these mistakes and remind yourself of them, so during the exam you can look out for these mistakes. This is something that's helped me massively and avoided a lot of silly mistakes, and make sure I get as many marks as I can. Ultimately, further maths requires the most perseverance, perhaps, of any A level. Do as much practice as you can. It can be very hard, but it can be very rewarding as well. I've linked to all my other How I Got an A Star videos down in the description below. So if you want to watch it for maths, physics, or chemistry, then feel free to check it out. Otherwise, if you found this video useful, leave a thumbs up and subscribe. If there is any questions you may have about the video, or any more advice you need, or suggestions you have for any videos, like avoiding silly mistakes and stuff like that, then leave a comment down below and let me know. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.